Hello, welcome to the tutorial of Digital Storage Oscilloscope. An oscilloscope is a device used to measure voltage against time in an electronic instrument. Oscilloscopes are of different types: analog, digital, digital storage oscilloscope, digital sampling oscilloscope, and so on. Analog oscilloscope comprises of a vertical amplifier, horizontal amplifier, power supply, time base, and a cathode ray tube. Analog oscilloscopes were popular between 1990s and early 2000. The oscilloscope present in our laboratory is the digital storage oscilloscope. The one significant feature of a digital storage oscilloscope is that it allows you to capture and view events that may happen only once, which are known as transients. DSOs provide permanent signal storage and extensive waveform processing. For measuring a signal, we require two connections, a probe tip connection and a ground connection. A CRO probe looks like this, which is connected to channel 1 and another probe is connected to channel 2. This means that we can observe two signals at most on the oscilloscope screen. The end of the CRO probe consists of a probe tip connection and a ground connection. The probe tip connection is directly connected to the point where we would like to check the output waveform, and the ground connection is connected to the common ground of the circuit, which results in a more stable waveform. Now, let us look at different control knobs on the DSO to understand better. We can see that on the oscilloscope display, there are two axes, the vertical axis and the horizontal axis. The vertical axis Y represents voltage and the horizontal axis X represents time. Intensity or brightness display is sometimes called the axis Z. As you can see, I've set up a circuit which results in a square waveform and is connected to the channel 2. We can observe that there are few control knobs for the vertical analysis and few control knobs for the horizontal analysis. And there is a pair of knobs for each channel. First, let us take a look at the vertical control knobs. If you want a signal to be displayed or you want it to be removed because it is unnecessarily displayed on the screen, we can press these two buttons. As this signal is connected to the channel 2, if you press the channel 2 button here, the channel is removed from the screen. If you want it to reappear again, you can press this button again. As channel 1 probe is not connected to any signal, if you press this button, we can see a straight line, that is a blank signal with little distortion. The vertical position control knob moves the waveform up and down to where you want it to be exactly on the screen so that you can analyze it better. Volts per division control knob is used to set a vertical scale factor, that is, you can increase or decrease the amplitude of the signal, that is, scale it to a factor of your choice. Now, the signal is scaled to a factor of 2 volts, which is displayed on the leftmost corner of the screen. Now, if you rotate the control knob, you can see that it has changed to 1 volt. Now, it has changed to 5 volts. Lastly, the math button allows you to perform operations on both the signals of the two channels. You can select the operation of your choice by pressing this button because this points to the first option under the math menu. So there are many operations under this control knob. Addition of two channels, subtraction of two channels, multiplication, fast Fourier transform and fast Fourier transform RMS. Now, let us take a look at each of the options provided in the channel 2's menu. One thing to remember is that whenever you want to select an option offered in the menu, you can press the corresponding button which points to that option you want to choose. And if you want to change the numeric value in any option, you can use the variable control knob to change the numeric value. First, coupling. Coupling is of three types: DC coupling, AC coupling and ground. DC coupling shows you the whole signal. AC coupling displays only the AC components present in the signal. And ground sets the display to 0 volts before you take any measurements. Invert option is useful to invert the signal whenever you want to. So by pressing this button, you can invert the signal or switch off the inversion option. Now let us take a look at the control knobs present in the horizontal section. There are three control knobs, as we can see. The first one is the horizontal position control knob. It moves the waveform left or right to exactly where you want it on the screen. The time per division lets you select the rate at which the waveform is drawn on the screen, so that you can analyze the frequency of the waveform correctly. The scaling factor is displayed at this point. And the menu option gives us all the following options, out of which XY mode is one of the most significant feature. XY mode converts the oscilloscope from voltage versus time to V in versus V out using two input channels. Next, let us take a look at other important control knobs on the DSO. If you find it difficult to analyze a running waveform like this, you can stop it for a while and analyze it better. For that, you need to press the run or stop button to stop it and press the button again to resume it. The waveform is stopped and you can read it better. If you want to resume the running waveform, press the button once again. Now let us stop the waveform for a while and analyze it. Usually, oscilloscopes are used to measure the frequency, period, the voltage, that is the peak-to-peak voltage or RMS voltage, Vmax, Vmin, Vaverage, and so on. So for that, there is a button called measure which gives you the direct values without you manually calculating them. So if you press the measure button, the following menu is displayed: VRMS, VPP, frequency, duty cycle, and rise time. As the channel 1 is off, there is only one value present at the channel 2. We can see that the VRMS voltage is 4.64 volts, peak to peak voltage is 5.8 volts, the frequency is 63.78 kHz, the duty cycle, as it is a square wave, 50%, and rise time 32 nanoseconds. If you want to change any of the parameters here, you can select any of the options and select time and hover the variable control knob to the desired parameter. If you want to check the fall time now, select the fall time by rotating the variable control knob and select time and press measure. The fall time of the signal, that is 101.2 nanoseconds, is displayed on the screen. Another important feature is the cursor button, which helps you in detailed examination of the signal. Once you press the cursor button, there are two cursors which help you in finding the frequency or the difference between the time periods of the signals. You can move the cursors one by one by selecting X1 or X2. Now the X2 is selected, you can change the position of the second cursor, and if you select X1, you can change the position of the X1 cursor. Now, as this is one time period, X1, X2, the frequency is given and the delta is given. You can press save or recall button to save or recall the oscilloscope setups or waveforms. By pressing save or recall and selecting the first default setup, you can see that the oscilloscope is set back to its default settings. The acquire menu helps you in setting acquisition parameters. The first option, normal, is used to acquire and accurately display most waveforms. Average ranges from 2 to 256, which is used to reduce random or uncorrelated noise in the displayed signal. The other control knobs like display, utility, help the user in setting the desired configurations. In display, there is contrast button, refresh, the type in which the screen is to be seen, the type, accumulate. In utility, there is a hard copy menu, drop compensation menu, language, system info, and so on. The help button helps us in understanding any key's functionalities, that is, when you press help and then press that particular key, you get the description of what the key does. So these are the functionalities of the different keys present on the DSO. A DSO can sometimes be used as a digital multimeter as well. Whenever you want to measure DC voltage between two points, just connect the probe tip connection to the positive side and ground it properly and press the measure button so that the DC voltage will be displayed on the screen. Though you won't be able to see the waveform of the DC voltage as there is no frequency. Thank you for watching.